Hello dear students, welcome to my channel Visual Physics Tutor, the best place to learn the concepts of physics in the most easiest and finest way. So today our topic will be to study about the torque on an electric dipole when it is placed in an uniform electric field. So you have studied about the torque in your 11th grade, so it is nothing but a force which allows an object to rotate. So here, and torque, the formula is torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. So now let us assume a uniform electric field. So we draw here a uniform electric field. Now let us assume that this side is the imaginary positive for the electric field. So this is the imaginary positive side of the electric field, and similarly this side is the imaginary negative of the electric field. Now we know that the direction of the electric dipole is always from the negative to positive, but the direction of the electric field is from positive to negative. So here we have drawn a uniform electric field starting from the positive and heading in the negative direction. So now let us place an electric dipole. So we have to construct an electric dipole now. For this, we place an electric dipole in this way. Now suppose here we have minus Q at point A, and here we have plus Q at point B. Now assume this minus Q and plus Q are equal in magnitude but opposite in charges, and they are separated by a small distance. That means now small vector distance. That means now they constitute an electric dipole. Now let the angle formed be theta. That means now this electric dipole, when given a certain force on certain conditions, may rotate within the electric field. So we have to see whether it will rotate or it will not rotate. Now we know that this electric field will exert a force. So here I can say the force exerted at point B will be F is equal to QE. Now similarly, the force exerted at point A will be also F is equal to QE. Now let us see now what we have to do. So we can consider a dipole of length 2A placed in a uniform electric field E. So we can write here, consider a dipole of length 2A placed in an electric field E. Now from the diagram we can know that, look here, there is a force on charge A. So force on charge Q minus Q placed at A. So we know that here F is equal to QE. Now what is the direction here? The direction will be actually opposite to the direction of the electric field. So it is opposite to direction of electric field. Now why do we say that it is opposite to the direction of the electric field? Because you can see here at point A, it is minus Q charge, and it is nearly in the close proximity of the imaginary positive of the electric field, so it will be attracted towards the other side. That means now it is moving against the direction of the electric field, so it is opposite to the direction of the electric field. Now similarly, we can take force on charge Q at B, so that is also F is equal to QE. But now here this will be in the direction of the electric field. Now why do we say here it is in the direction of the electric field? Here you can see that at point B it is plus Q charge, and the direction of the electric field is heading in the negative direction. That means when at point A negative charge Q, when it is attracted towards the imaginary positive side of the electric field, the plus Q charge at point B is actually attracted towards the negative side of the electric field. So that means now you can see that it is moving in the direction of the electric field. So now we have to find the total force on the dipole. So the total force on the dipole will be, now you can see that at point B it is F is equal to QE, and at point A also it is F is equal to QE, but it is negative in charge, so I can write here QE minus QE is equal to 0. So what does this imply? It implies that here the dipole experiences no translatory motion. So now the dipole experiences no translatory motion. But now when it doesn't move in a translatory motion means it doesn't move this way. But then of course there is a rotatory motion about its axis. That means now if I say the electric dipole which is in this direction does not move this way, that means now there is no translatory motion. But in fact, since there is a force in this direction and there is a force in this direction, but they are equal in magnitude, now there is every possibility to rotate this way. Now this rotational force is called as the torque. So I can say here, but there is rotation. Now the torque on the dipole can be represented as, now you know that torque is given by the magnitude of the force into the perpendicular distance. So torque is equal to F. Now we have to get the perpendicular distance. So how do we note the perpendicular distance here? So for getting the perpendicular distance, what I can do here, you can check with the diagram. From the point B, I can draw a perpendicular in this direction. So now I can say this is N here. Now here this BN is perpendicular line. So I can write here tau is equal to force into the perpendicular distance, that is now BN. Let us consider this as equation 1. Now let us consider triangle ABN. So from triangle ABN, we can see that here sin theta is equal to BN by AB. From here we can write BN is equal to AB sine theta. But now what is AB? It is the dipole length, which is equal to 2A. But AB is equal to 2A. So here, now this can be rewritten as BN is equal to 2A sine theta. Now this can be substituted in equation 1. So I can write here, this is equation 2. So I write here, substituting the value of BN from equation 2 in equation 1. So I can write here, tau is equal to F and into 2A sine theta. But here, what is F? From the diagram, we know that F is equal to QE. So I can write here, but F is equal to QE. Now we can substitute this value in this equation. So now we get here, tau is equal to QE 2A sine theta. Now from the definition of dipole moment, we know that P is equal to Q into 2A. So, but P is equal to Q to 2A. Now this can be substituted in this equation. So we can write now tau is equal to, now instead of 2A and Q, I can write it as P. So we write it as P. Now what is remaining here? E and sine theta. Now that means we get tau is equal to PE sine theta. Now to put in the vector notation, we can remove the sine theta here. So now tau vector is equal to P cross E vector cross E vector. So now this is the formula for the torque on an electric dipole placed in a uniform electric field. Now when can be the maximum torque be obtained? The maximum torque can be obtained when theta is equal to 90 degree, because when it is sine 90, it is 1. So we can write here, the maximum torque can be obtained when theta is equal to 90 degree. Now substituting this value, so we can write, otherwise we can write tau is equal to PE. Hope you have understood this simple derivation, and thanks.